Hi, I'm Catherine, and we're at the Mountain Thread Company in Blowing Rock. And today we're going to talk about machine settings, thread choice, and choosing a needle to be able to sew your own coiled rope baskets. Now, if you remember in the other video, we talked about what kind of rope to use. This is our custom braid of rope. It's 100% cotton and it's a solid braid. And that's what we're going to be using as we make coiled rope baskets. So the first thing that we're going to talk about is thread choice. What you see right here, we have a few different spools of thread. I kind of collected a few spools that I had around, and one of them is going to be more suitable than the others. So this thread right here, it's really nice, it's pretty, it's variegated, lots of colors going on in there, but this is actually a 40 weight thread. And 40 weight or 30 weight, 28 weight, the lower the thread weight number, the thicker the thread. So we actually don't really want a thick thread when we're sewing coiled rope baskets because the rope itself is pretty thick. And a thick thread having to punch through the rope is going to really stress the thread and it may break. So you actually want a 50 weight thread. And that's kind of your more common all-purpose machine quilting or machine sewing thread. So 30 weight, 40 weight thread, that's out. These two spools right here, these were actually in a box that I inherited. So this one, it looks really cool. This is a 29-cent spool. We'll call it vintage. It is not desirable because the older the thread, the worse quality it is. So thread can actually break down over time. So if you inherited some spools of thread, even if they look like it might be the right weight or it's a color that's desirable, it's probably not the best option because of the age of the thread. And again, you're trying to punch the thread through a heavy duty rope, a really strong, sturdy rope. So the cheaper the thread or the more brittle the thread, it's gonna break and that's gonna be frustrating. So both of those are out. This thread here, this is a 50 weight brand. It's Aurifil, and that's what I typically prefer. There are other brands out there that are gonna serve you pretty well. So a couple positive things about this, 50 weight, if you remember, that's the weight of thread that is most common for machine sewing and machine quilting. And it's thin enough that it's going to be able to go through the rope and pull back out and make the stitches that you want. It comes in a lot of colors, which is also pretty awesome. But it's a really high quality thread. So you pay a little bit more for it, but it's actually very worth it because it's not going to be breaking. It's not going to be stressing the thread or the needle while you're doing your project. So out of all of our thread options, again, you want the right weight of thread and you want a good quality of thread, not something that's old, not something that's too heavy or too dense for the project. All right, let's set our sewing machine settings. All right, so here we are ready to set the sewing machine to be able to sew our coiled rope baskets. And the first thing that we want to do is set the machine to a zigzag stitch. Now on this particular machine, I'm going to use this button right here to change to a zigzag. But the preset that's here, I actually want to make the stitch wider than it is. So right here, I'm going to adjust my stitch width right there. Now you may have a button like this, or it may be a knob to turn, but you want to set your zigzag stitch as wide as it will go in order to be able to zig on one piece of rope and zag on the other while you're making your coiled rope baskets. So you have the zigzag stitch, you have it set as wide as it will go, and you also want to change the stitch length from the preset. So right now it's at about 2 millimeters, which is pretty good. You can go between 2 and 3 millimeters. So we're gonna go up to 2.5 millimeters for the start of our basket. So we have the zigzag stitch, we have it set as wide as it will go, and we have the stitch length about 2.5 millimeters. The next thing that we're gonna look at is changing out the machine needle. So one of the things you want to think about while you're sewing with this really sturdy 100% cotton rope, this is kind of like layers of denim. It's kind of like hemming a pair of jeans. So you want a needle that can handle that. This right here is a universal jeans needle. It's a size 16. And if you look right here, you've got a blue band on the needle. And so if you have some different needles that you have available to you, if one of them has a blue band, then that's the basically surefire way of knowing that that's a needle that's suitable for jeans. So you want to take that needle and you want to put that in your sewing machine according to the manufacturer's suggestion. So pull out your manual, change out your needle, and you'll be ready to go. Okay, now that we know our machine settings, the zigzag stitch, the width and the length of the stitch, and the needle, you're ready to start sewing your baskets. Now, in each of our kits that we have here at the Mountain Thread Company, we have these instructions. So I have the instructions on what kind of stitch to do on your sewing machine, setting the width, setting the length, and then we always include a heavy duty needle. So basically, you can take any of the kits that we have and you can get going right away. All right, so we're ready. We have our sewing machine settings, we know what kind of rope we're gonna use, and we know what kind of thread we're gonna use. All right, let's get sewing.